Does an EV make sense if you can't charge at home? I bought a secondhand EV and I can't charge it at home. Was that a crazy decision? After 3 months, this is what I've learned about charging an EV solely on public chargers in Canberra, Australia. First, let's talk about cost. I've paid anywhere between 25 cents and $1.56 per kilowatt hour. For reference, 25 cents per kilowatt hour is actually cheaper than charging off the grid at home, but $1.56 per kilowatt hour works out to about $40 to drive 150 kilometers in a small car, more expensive than a petrol car, almost certainly. My average has been around 63 cents per kilowatt hour, and over 1,000 kilometers, I've spent about $130, which is probably a bit less than I would have spent on petrol. So in terms of cost, it's pretty equivalent, but it could be a lot cheaper if I was willing to sacrifice some convenience. Speaking of convenience, when I first got the car, I was living in a rented home pretty close to the city. There was a BYO cable charger at the nearby Croatian club. Great for dinner on a Friday night, by the way. It was just a 2-minute walk from my place, so I could charge there all day at 7 kilowatts for 40 cents per kilowatt hour while I worked from home, and then pick up the car in the afternoon. It was easy, cheap, and pretty much perfect. But then we moved. We bought the house, so we can and will eventually install a home charger, but for now, I don't have a place I can plug it in, even to a wall outlet, without running a really long extension cable, which is not really recommended. So I've been trying to find good charge options. I can charge extremely cheaply at a BYO cable charger near the bouldering gym, but I don't go that often and I don't stay long enough to get that much charge in. I can charge at a fast charger near work, but that is really expensive. So it's currently not very convenient at all. To get cheap charging, I need to go way out of my way. And to be honest, I don't need that extra stress and extra time out of my day. My conclusion, at the old place where I had access to a cheap, slow charger nearby, it was perfect. It was hardly any different from charging at home and way better than going to a petrol station every couple of weeks. But now it's way more hassle than it's worth, and it's making me enjoy the EV owner lifestyle a whole lot less. So, does it make sense to own an EV if you can't charge at home? I'd say take a look at how many cheap slow chargers are near where you work or live. And if that's an option, then yes, it can work and it will be amazing. But we clearly need a lot more chargers of this type if people who rent or live in apartments are going to start buying EVs en masse.